morning and welcome to the Pasco County Schools Transportation South CNG Facility Ribbon Cutting Ceremony. My name is Andrew Frazier and I'm with Integral Energy. Before we begin the program, I would like to acknowledge our elected officials. First, Senator Wilton Simpson. Thank you for being here, sir. And our school board members, Alan Altman, Colleen Bodwin, Cynthia Armstrong, Steve Lookert, and Allison Crumbly. A project such as this takes vision, community support, and teamwork. My involvement with this program first began in 2011 when I worked for Teco Energy. There's a young man here by the name of Jimmy Atcock who does community relations for Teco Energy who was gracious enough to bring me north of State Road 54 to introduce me to Pasco County. I had a chance to spend some time with Mr. Ray Gadd and his staff and a young aspiring chicken farmer who wanted to get into politics and Senator Wilton Simpson to start talking about and educating on CNG and alternative fuel vehicles. During those meetings, there were a lot of questions asked about natural gas and CNG as a transportation fuel. But one of the things that really stood out to me was, you know, both of these men wanted to understand what type of impact alternative fuel vehicles and CNG could have, not only on Pasco County and the Bay Area, but on Florida as a whole as it relates to economic development, environmental stewardship, and the safety for our kids. And it's hard to believe 6 years later that vision is finally coming to fruition. With the correlation of this project, not only does Pasco County Schools become the first school district to own and operate its own CNG facility, it also joins the likes of the Hillsborough Aviation Authority, the City of Clearwater, Hillsborough Area Regional Transit, the City of Tampa, J.J. Taylor Distributing, Waste Management, Waste Connections, Republic Waste, Dillon Transport, and Saddle Creek Transportation, and making the Bay Area the CNG capital of the state of Florida. The community support we receive from here in the likes of Tallahassee in terms of the alternative fuel vehicle rebate program spearheaded by Senator Simpson and shepherded by organizations such as FNGA, Dale Calhoun, and the City of Clearwater and Clearwater Gas and Tampa Bay Clean Cities has been an overwhelming success since its inception. Efforts like this will need to continue to take CNG and alternative fuel vehicles to the next level. Lastly, none of this happens without having a great team. And this great team was led under the stewardship and leadership of the Pasco County Schools Construction Department. A.D. Morgan, where are you? Trillium CNG, Hardeman and Kempton, Coastal Engineering, Holmes Architects, Marmer Construction, and my Integral Energy team with a host of other subs helped bring this project together. Please give them all a hand. Now I'd like to ask Mr. Kurt Browning, Pasco County Superintendent of Schools, to come to the podium and tell us how we actually got here.
Thank you, sir. I'm trying to figure out how we got here, but I am glad we are here. This is a great day for the Pasco District, and before I start my comments, I want to take just a moment and thank the J.W. Mitchell High School band for being here today. Thank you, thank you, thank you. When I got here this morning, I asked them, I said, how many of you are seniors? And a good, all the seniors, raise your hand. These guys got out of school on Friday, so they're looking forward to graduation, and we're just thankful you're here. I also want to take a moment and thank Joanne Hurley. Joanne Hurley is a former school board member that just rotated off the board within the last year and a half or so, and she was part of the decision-making process when we embarked on this project. So thanks for being here, Joanne. Did I say something? It seems like a year and a half. And I don't know if that's an indictment on you or Colleen, but it seems like, or me, maybe me. We are excited to be here today. Pasco County Schools, we've tried to be good stewards of our natural resources. The Construction Services Department has been recognized as a leader in environmental and sustainable school design. Not just with this facility, following the strategies of LEED, Leadership in Energy and Environmental Design, as well as Green Globes, the district has achieved numerous certifications ranging from basic LEED certification to gold certification. We have one facility that's gold certified, four that are silver, three that are LEED, and five schools designated to LEED Green Globe standards. Our maintenance department, despite rising temperatures and additional square footage added to district inventory, between 2010 and 2013, The district has reduced its energy consumption by over 1.5 million kilowatt hours, and that translates to about 1,000 less tons of carbon dioxide released into our environment. Our transportation department, as you may have heard, is the first school district in Florida to own and operate its own compressed natural gas fast fill station, and we are thrilled about this. Our transportation service department has emerged as a leader in Florida's environmental school bus transportation initiative. In 2010, with the help of Senator Wilton Simpson and Ag Commissioner Adam Putnam, the district participated in a state grant for the Clean Diesel Project, which outfitted 129 buses with diesel oxidation catalysts to help improve the emissions of those buses, our older buses, and we have a number of them out there. We've also looked at our natural gas and propane vehicle rebates. We've up to 50% of the incremental cost, as well as $25,000 per vehicle, up to $250,000, and we're appreciative of that, Senator. Thank you very, very much. Coupled with a bus replacement plan that allowed for more efficient and cleaner diesel engines, engine technologies to replace older ones, the district has kept pace with the strict EPA emissions regulations. In 2013, the district began purchasing propane-powered buses and liquefied petroleum gas fueling stations, which now serve East Pasco. The use of propane actually resulted in up to 20% less nitrogen oxide, 60% less carbon monoxide, and 24% fewer greenhouse gas emissions throughout our district. This facility features a fast-fill CNG station and will house up to 90 CNG buses when it's fully staffed. We've also integrated alternative fuels for the last number of years. Starting in 14-15, we purchased 13 propane buses. In the 15-16 school year, we purchased 33. In this school year, we've purchased 30 CNG buses, and then 17-18 next year, we'll be purchasing 35 CNG and the diesel buses. We are committed. This board is committed to purchasing 35 new buses annually for the next 10 years. And we're excited about today and the new era that this opens for us. But before I conclude, I would be absolutely remiss if, you know, I get a lot of kudos because of things that I do, but I will tell you, and I've said this all along, it's about the people that you have surrounding you. And the folks that make me look good are many of them are here today, but I want to mention one particular, that's Ray Gadd. Ray's the deputy superintendent, and a lot of times he's behind the scenes causing problems. I have to go back in, clean them up. But seriously, Ray's the one that took the initiative and really started pushing us on this project. And we were at a crossroads when we knew that we had not been buying buses. We had to start buying buses. So what kind of buses do we want to buy, and what's the best thing to do? And it was Ray's leadership and his initiative that got us to this point today. So Ray, from this superintendent, and I can speak on behalf of the school board, thank you for your leadership in this project. Enjoy.
When the superintendent said that Ms. Hurley had been off the board for a year and a half, it reminded me he must have gone to the same math class as our host, who said that Jimmy Adcock was the young man from TECO. I only say that because he's a great guy, and we met how many years ago at my office? Why don't you move into the shade? I mean, your forehead's going to get burned. We met, okay, 2009 when I was on the board to start talking about this, and I had three little handwritten notes on myself. One was to thank Joanne Hurley, which the superintendent has already done, and then one was to thank Senator Simpson for clarifying and assisting in some of the information that we got at the beginning. And then lastly was Ray Gadd for his leadership. One of the things that I've learned since being elected 10 years ago is that there are a lot of people who say we've never done it that way before. And one of the things that I can say about our staff of professionals led by Mr. Gadd is that they don't allow that to be a hindrance to anything. And so you will find this district has been on the cutting edge of a lot of really progressive things around the state of Florida, and they are looked to for their expertise because they've done the research and they've not been afraid to think outside the box at things that have saved taxpayers money And this is an example of one of those. When we first started looking at compressed natural gas as an alternative, we looked at several different companies that may have been able to come in and build a station for us. But the more research was done, the more it was determined that we could save taxpayers money and have more control of the situation by having our own facility. So that's what you see today. They provided me some interesting information for those of you that are into it. There are over 10,000 feet of electrical conduit underground at this facility. All the piping for the compressed natural gas, because we had questions about this at the beginning of safety, was tested to in excess of 5,500 pounds per square inch for over an hour, so it's met all the safety tests. They can fuel a bus in 3 minutes. Not quite NASCAR standards, but a whole lot faster than I would have expected. All of the compression equipment that you see on site here today was manufactured in the United States of America and shipped here and installed. And each of these buses is estimated to reduce CO2 emissions by over 20,000 pounds annually. For those of us as board members, we grapple with growth. And since I've been on the board for 10 years, I'd have to say that that's the number one issue we face. And this station is centrally located in what the county projects to be the fastest growing area for years ahead. This area is projected to grow by over 1,000 students annually. And so it is on our long-term master plan to have a bus facility here because it's centrally located, it saves time for our drivers and saves money for taxpayers and provides better service for our students and schools. And so that all came together to be able to have a facility that we had purchased knowing that we needed a bus facility here in this area of the county to do this with the compressed natural gas station and have all of that come together and allow us to serve the taxpayers and students more efficiently. So I want to, on behalf of the board, to thank everybody that was involved, from the guys that started with the visionary idea to the people that laid the asphalt that we stand on today. We thank you for your time and your service and the contribution that you made to help us serve our students. So thank you so much.
6 years ago when I was running for the Senate, we did have a lunch with Andrick and Jimmy Adcock and others, and because I was running around the county and my district at that time, saying we need to use more natural gas. We need to have less dependency on foreign oil. We need to reduce the cost of our fuel. If you go to the gas station today, you're at $2.50 to $2.75 on gasoline. And the more natural gas that we use to fuel our vehicles, I believe eventually diesel and gasoline is going to have to compete with natural gas. There's going to be a tipping point, and we're going to drive down those costs of those other fuels. That provides billions of dollars of stimulus to our economy, because everyone that drove here today on $2.50 gas filled up for $45 in their car instead of $75 like it was 3 or 4 years ago when it was $4 gasoline. And so we have that additional disposable income to stimulate the economy of the state of Florida. And then when you say that, that's a big deal. But then look at the reduction of pollution that we can create and the environment that we can create in the state of Florida by using this alternative fuel. And so when you couple all of those things together and you decide you're gonna run for office, and that's was sort of my lead notion, that we should be more energy independent, we should reduce fuel costs around the state, we should reduce pollution around the state, and all the time creating thousands of jobs in the state for Floridians, I wasn't sure how we could go wrong. And so we spent a lot of time. I was very proud of the bill that we did. We ended up doing a bill that incentivized folks to buy natural gas rebate program to buy these vehicles, up to $25,000 per vehicle rebate, because there was additional costs initially to buy these vehicles until they become more in mass production, and obviously that will drive the cost down. So the idea was, if you buy these buses, then you're going to have to build a fueling station. And so it's a very proud day to stand here in Pasco County 5 years later, 6 years after our meeting, and have a natural gas fueling station here in Pasco County, owned by the school board, and we're very proud of that, and the opportunities that this will bring to the Tabasco County. And lastly, I would say that Superintendent Gadd is everything that you heard today. If I talked to him one time about this thing, I probably talked to him 100 times about it. And he was a leader in bringing this facility here and continuing to be a strong supporter of Pasco County and Pasco County schools. So thank you for having me here today. And again, it's just nice to see that sometimes these things actually work out the way you expect them to. Thanks.
Pasco County Commissioner Mike Moore.
Thank you. Well, good morning, everybody. And just to reiterate what Alan was saying earlier, this is one of the fastest growing, obviously, areas, not only in Pasco County, but in the state and the nation. So we are expected to be at, we're just reached the 505,000 plateau here in Pasco County. 2030, we're looking at 750,000 residents. And we're estimated being at 1 million residents by 2040. So I'm sure Ray and Superintendent Browning, you're getting prepared for that now, right?
We are getting prepared. Thank you for your help.
You're good. You got. We're not talking impact fees today,
no,
right?
We're not
okay.
Talking impact fees.
Okay. Good.
Unless you want. Unless you want to.
Let's stay focused. Let's stay focused. Okay. But on behalf of the Pasco County Board of County Commissioners, I want to thank you for allowing me to be here today. To commemorate the grand opening of the Pasco Schools compressed natural gas facility. So on behalf of the commission, I also want to applaud the efforts of the district to ensure a cleaner, brighter future for Pasco County and its residents. And it hits close to home with me, too. I have three children that go to Pasco County Schools. My wife is also a Pasco County School nurse. So we do appreciate everything you're doing for my children and for my wife and everybody's future. As Superintendent Browning mentioned, in 2013, the district began purchasing the propane-powered buses and liquefied propane gas fueling stations, which now serve East Pasco. And the district's use of propane has yielded the following results: 20% less nitrogen oxide, 60% less carbon monoxide, and 24% fewer greenhouse gas emissions. And the facility that's opening behind me today, a fast fill CNG station, will house up to 90 CNG buses. So if you compare that to the current diesel buses, these buses produce 13% less greenhouse gas, 95% less nitrogen oxide, and 80% less hydrocarbon. And there's also many advantages to using alternative fuels like this: reduced vehicle noise, which I'm sure we'll all be thrilled about in the mornings, cleaner emissions, and lower contamination risk. Obviously, we know it's an abundant resource, like Senator Simpson obviously previously mentioned. Less price volatility, easier budget management, domestically produced, and no CNG transport cost. So this CNG fill station is a result of a dedication to efficiency and saving taxpayers' dollars, and also a cleaner, brighter future for Pasco County. So on behalf of the Pasco County Board of County Commissioners, I want to thank Superintendent Browning, Assistant Superintendent Gadd, all the school board members for looking out for the citizens of Pasco County, keeping us safe, and looking out for our children's and their future. So thank you very much.
Well, it's very difficult to fuel CNG buses without gas. So this next man has plenty of it. Chuck Warrington.
The guy with gas, right? Well, we're real proud to be here. Clearwater Gas System, we started about 6 years ago. Our city looked at what do we need to do to make ourselves green. One of the big pollutants was the transportation sector, and so Clearwater Gas, owned by the city of Clearwater, we decided to build a natural gas station, the first in the state of Florida. Was built in Clearwater for principally the solid waste fleet. We have about 45 of our solid waste trucks now. About half our fleet is already converted over to natural gas. Our utility vehicles, and then probably seven or eight other clients in the area with trucks, other solid waste vehicles and other vehicles. So we've been operating now for about 6 years. We started about the same time as Senator Simpson started on the process. We really appreciated that. We had a little bit of help from the federal government early on, and the state government, and the tax credits that he helped us get. Natural gas, you've heard already, it is cleaner, environmentally friendly, great as we build the population up in the areas and whatever to decrease the amount of pollutants in our environment. It's economical. We really look forward to seeing the difference between CNG use in these buses and the propane that's been used over the last couple of years. It's domestically available. It's the United States fuel. You know, we've got more natural gas in America than Saudi Arabia has oil. So this is great for our national economy and great for our energy independence. And it's reliable. It's here. It's going to be here. It's available when we have storms and whatever. You're not going to see the natural gas not be available. One of the things from an availability standpoint, I would thank our TECO People's Gas participants here. As we built from the west side of the county towards the east, we recognized that we had a liability that what happens if someone digs into our line and that kind of thing. So we made a connection with TECO People's Gas on State Road 54, so we've got a backup from the east in case anything happens. We can ensure that the gas will be available for the school here, and that was a big deal. In fact, we believe that we're the first utility in the state that two utilities got together and have interconnected, and we've done that about five or six places around our system to ensure reliability. I want to, you know, 6 years ago when we started our station, one of the first people we talked to were Pasco County School Board. They started at that time coming in and talking about what we were doing and how we were, what we were planning, and told us that they were planning on doing this down the road too. And so we really appreciate what you did to make this actually happen. And so we thank all the partners. This is a lot of people involved, Trillium and everybody else involved. And thanks for what you do. And we're proud to be a partner in this endeavor. Thanks very much.
We're almost at the end of this thing, and without a great leader, general manager, coach, none of this stuff is possible. So last, we'll bring up Ray Gann.
Since we're close to the end, I'll just make a few comments. But about 9 years ago, I was sitting in a conference room, and we were dealing with a problem that was, for lack of a better term, kind of government created. And someone threw up their arms and said, well, that's government. As if they were going to give up on it. And I've always lived with a belief that government can be better. Every day, government can be better. And this is an example today of government being better. I want to thank a few people that have been involved in this project. And long before I got the idea to get with my team and work on this, people were whispering behind the scenes. Alan Altman, Wilton Simpson. When he comes back to town, we can call him Wilton Simpson, because Wilton Simpson's our friend. He's Pasco County's friend. And he was our friend long before he was a senator. And now that he's a senator, he's even a better friend. So he was talking about CNG. Alan Altman was talking about CNG. One of the first people I contacted and talked to about it was Jimmy Adcock. And thank you, Jimmy. I want to thank the school board, because our school board and our superintendent create a culture where people are encouraged to think outside of the box and are encouraged to get things done. I want to start with Chris Williams, because Chris Williams, unbeknownst to people, bought this property on behalf of the school board, and he bought it at recession level prices. So we have a piece of commercial property that we got at good value, and he had the foresight to buy it and to buy additional land down the street. I want to thank John Petrashek. Where's John? He may not be here this morning. I want to thank John Petrashek for all his hard work, because we put this thing into action quick and got it done for this school year. But some of the people that really need a big thank you that haven't been mentioned today are Gary Sawyer. You guys step up here. Gary Sawyer, Emmett Thompson, and Tad Kledzik. Come on. These guys run our transportation department along with others, but they were involved in this process from the get-go. And once we got the diesel fumes out of their nose and got rolling on this project, they have absolutely become experts on compressed natural gas. Tad is traveling about the country talking about what we're doing here in Pasco County. And so I really want to thank them. I appreciate all their hard work. Finance, Olga Swenson is here somewhere with her team, and they've worked on the contracts. They've worked hard on putting the financial mechanism for making this happen together, and they've just done an incredible, incredible job. They've been on the phone working on contract issues, working on gas issues, purchasing, who worked on this process and it had a little bit different kind of way that we put things together, but they made it seamless and they made it legal, which is always good. I want to thank Clearwater Gas, because when we started working on this, Clearwater Gas rolled out the red carpet. And we went over and saw their facility, and it was their facility that led us to believe that we could be the first school system in the state of Florida to own and operate our own gas facility. Up until that point, we were dealing with some private financiers who were going to put together a proposal for us where they were basically going to finance this. And we were going to wind up saving, I don't remember, Tad, 15 or 20 cents on a gallon. And I can assure you, by owning it, operating it, we're going to save a lot more than that on a diesel gallon equivalent. So we're really excited about what's occurring here today. I want to thank Andrick for, he kind of came along after we were talking with Clearwater Gas. He's done a tremendous job. This has been a project that has kind of happened without hiccups so far. We haven't got to the first day of school yet, Andrew, but I'll be standing out here waiting. But so far, this project has just gone beautifully, and I want to thank all of my staff, even the folks that I may have left out and not mentioned, for all of their hard work. This is really a great day for Pasco. It's a great day for the taxpayers. Thank you.